I am Renee Seltzer, and we are creating a whole series called Agency Confidential, and that is where we are helping businesses like yours help identify how to drive more leads and revenue. And after this specific video, you are going to be able to figure out how to improve your conversion rate. So you're actually going to have a set of action items to tackle and take back to your team and really make some big gains. So I'm excited to show them to you. One of the first ones that I always see is this thing called the leaky bucket. So in this leaky bucket, I'm just gonna tell you about it. Businesses keep adding paid search and SEO, right? And no matter what they add, what happens to all their lead flow, all right? It just keeps leaking out and you have no idea how to diagnose this. This is a little bit heavy and it's getting on my shoes. So you have no idea how to diagnose this problem. You know what's happening, you don't know how to fix it. And what happens is you just keep putting more and more and more money into the leaky bucket. And I'm gonna walk you through all the different ways. Wow. So I hope this is a helpful leaky bucket. You can keep throwing money at the problem, keep doing more SEO. How many times have you redone your website and it's still not getting you what you need, right? Why are these leads not converting? I have no idea, right? Actually, I do know. Let's start with the whole leads and sales thing. I'm gonna put this down and this will just keep doing this for a really long time. Here, we'll water some plants with it. So tell me if this happens in your company, right? Sales and marketing aren't in alignment, and what kind of conversations do they normally have?
We need more leads. Yeah, but we need more sales. We need more leads to get more sales. Yeah, but your leads are no good. What are you talking about? Your sales are no good. My leads are fine.
So there's a lot of finger pointing going on, right? We're totally going user gen here. So we're gonna set the shenanigans aside. I just wanted to give you some visuals of what happens with that leaky bucket. All right, so recently I went through a client. I just wanted to walk you through this scenario and tell you this story to help illustrate all the unintentional holes you might have in your leaky bucket. So I had another agency come to me and they asked me to audit one of their clients' paid search accounts. And you know, on the surface, they had an $800 cost per lead, and that does seem high. But if they're converting that into a $50,000 new kit, we'd all do that all day long. I'd pay $800 to get $50,000. I'd keep doing it. So I wanted to go ahead and really dig into the account and really unearth all the potential friction points and things that are causing them to have those holes in their bucket, because maybe they could be converting more of those leads. How do we plug up the leaky bucket before we keep throwing more money into it? Okay, so I started auditing the paid search account. Some things I noticed right away: the landing page didn't have a strong call to action. If anything, I actually really had to find my way to figure out how to become a lead. Second, they didn't have different landing pages for those ad groups, which really helps your quality score. Okay, easy enough to fix. But this is the cincher. This is what I don't think they knew, and how I go a little bit deeper to diagnose problems is I went to their website, I filled out a lead, as any other person will. I didn't go through paid search, so it didn't cost them anything. And so I filled out a lead on Saturday morning. Guess what happened? Can you guess? Well, let me tell you what happened. Absolutely nothing. I didn't even get an email that said, oh, I got your info, someone's gonna contact you on Monday. Let me tell you one thing about this, so I'm gonna do a quick timeout, that your first email you send is the most open email you're gonna have. Do not squander it with transactional emails like, hey, I got your info. That's transactional. Put a video, tell your story, help them understand what the next thing is gonna be. Use that email to its absolute full advantage. In this case of this client, an email that was transactional would have been better than what they did, which was a big fat zero. They didn't do anything. Okay, so Saturday morning, I filled out a lead form. I didn't get a call, I didn't get an email, I got nothing. No idea what happened. Sunday goes by, same thing. Monday, the guy does call me and I'm like, hi. And he goes, did you fill out a lead form? And I'm like, yes, I did. And I do want to talk to you. Can you call me back in an hour? Which I did with intention, because that's how you check yourself, right? You can't diagnose problems if you don't kind of run them through the ringer a variety of different ways. And the guy's like, yeah, okay, I can call you back. Guess what? Did he call me back? Nope. He never called me back. I never heard from the company again. So if that really was a lead that kind of comes out to be $800 on paid click, imagine that business owner if he knew that $800 was just lit on fire. Statistically, there's this research that shows that you need 6 different touch points through a variety of channels, which could be phone, email, social. Do you know on average how many times a sales rep does reach out to a prospect? 2. So your sales reps are generally grossly under communicating and reaching out to prospective people. So that's another hole in your bucket that you need to diagnose. What is your communication sequence? The beautiful thing of having a CRM and having a communication sequence is that if your sales rep is having a bad day that day, or maybe you have high turnover and you have a new sales rep that's just figuring things out, your CRM, if set up correctly, could go ahead and continue nurturing and getting that prospect to be more sales ready. 70% of people who come to your website actually actively choose not to go into your funnel in the first place, no matter how much SEO and paid search and everything else you're driving. That means something on your website didn't do a good enough job sharing value. So here are the action items that I want you to take away from today. 1, make sure you have really great converting landing pages. Are your calls to actions really strong? Are you clearly communicating how you're solving pain points? Are you building trust with social proof? The next one is make sure you have a CRM set up. So an example that I gave you, when that lead comes through, you want your CRM to kick out an email. And not just any email, you need it to have video and really tell your story and continue building value to get those prospects to become more sales ready. Another one is make sure you have a communication sequence. So like a lead nurturing sequence. How do you tell your story over time? Remember, nobody wants to be sold to, but everyone wants to buy. And let's have a lot of empathy for how hard it is to buy, right? Like there's a million companies to decide from. Every day we have to make a million different kinds of choices. It's maddening. So really important that you show how easy it is to work with you, how you have a lot of social proof. And if you feel like through any of this that we could help you accomplish these goals and help you diagnose the friction points in your buyer's funnel from marketing to sales and sales alignment, please do call us. Our contact info is right below, so you could schedule a call. We really look forward to, you know, kind of kicking off a conversation and seeing what's next. Have a great day, and I hope you found this super valuable. Be sure to like, follow, and subscribe, depending what channel you're watching this on. Each channel has a different button, so I'll just do this. All right, I just think this is so funny. Hey, you need more leads? You need more leads? How about more sales? I had some that fell off a truck. You want them? You want the leads? You want the sales? I got them. Call me. I'll get you leads. I'll get you sales. Come on.